RadioPlanner 3 is a comprehensive tool ideally suited for planning private 5G and LTE networks across various frequency bands, including the CBRS. This video will showcase the key features of RadioPlanner 3 for planning 5G and LTE networks within the CBRS band. For more details, please refer to the user manual on our website. You can also download the software and try out all its features during a 7-day trial period. Several test projects are available in the installation folder to help you get started. This project uses the default digital terrain model and clutter model, which are automatically downloaded from our server and are suitable for most cases. You can also use a custom digital terrain model and clutter data in GeoTIFF format. For more information about how to use custom geodata, please refer to the user manual. You can select one of the preset base maps or configure a custom base map by specifying a tile server URL. Map navigation is performed with a mouse. Use the mouse wheel to zoom in or out on the map. In the Map Layers menu, you can control which layers are displayed on the map. The order of the layers in the menu corresponds to their order on the map, with the base map at the bottom and sites at the top of all the layers. In the Map Layers menu, you can configure the display of sites, turn on or off coverage, routes for route study, study boundary, clutter, terrain, and base map. You can also control the transparency of some layers, and you can set the range of displayed heights on the terrain layer in automatic or manual mode. You can load and display point or linear vector objects in KML format as a layer on the map. This can include objects such as power lines, piping, etc. In this example, as a custom layer, I am using candidate antenna towers from Crown Castle, which are loaded from a CSV file. The designation used is the height of the tower in feet. Main system parameters are entered in the network menu. Select the appropriate system type, 5G or LTE. In this section, you'll set the downlink and uplink frequencies used to calculate path losses between the base station and user equipment. For time division duplex mode, the frequencies will be identical. You can also define the threshold signal levels for these calculations. Specify the maximum calculation radius from the base station here. To reduce computation time, avoid setting an excessive radius. The System Parameters tab allows you to configure additional critical network parameters. Choose the duplex mode, frequency division duplex, or time division duplex. Set the bandwidth, LTE cyclic prefix, and TDD uplink to downlink ratio for TDD systems. If your network employs the fractional frequency reuse technique, it's necessary to set the ratio of resource blocks in the reuse 1 and reuse 3 zones, as well as the carrier to interference plus noise ratio threshold for switching between these zones. Enter the average cell load as a percentage from 0 to 100. Cell loading is assumed to be uniform. In the channel table, list all potential uplink and downlink frequencies for the network. For TDD systems, input the same frequency for both. The 3GPP downlink and uplink tables include the MCS index, modulation type, and transport block size. You can specify minimum CINR values for both uplink and downlink. The default values in this table are based on published MATLAB simulations of LTE radio performance. Throughput for each modulation index is calculated from the 3GPP tables, considering the transport block size, but not the MIMO multiplier. This menu enables you to apply correction factors for multiple input, multiple output, and space division multiple access systems. MIMO systems, which use multiple antennas at both ends of the communication link, can significantly improve a wireless communication system when paired with advanced signal processing techniques. SDMA can increase capacity by reusing system resources and reallocating them to UEs separated in space. This table is fully customizable for various downlink and uplink scenarios. In the Noise and Interference tab, set the noise characteristics of the receivers, including equivalent noise bandwidth, noise figure, and adjacent channel rejection. These parameters are crucial for noise and interference calculations. For 5G systems, the parameters menu is similar, with minor differences. Here, you can select the duplex mode, bandwidth, subcarrier spacing configurations, and allocate TDD resources for downlink. The tables contain the MCS index, modulation type, target code rate, and minimum signal to interference ratio values for both uplink and downlink. Throughput calculations are based on the 3GPP tables. The remaining tabs mirror those for LTE systems. RadioPlanner predicts coverage for two user equipment types with distinct characteristics such as height and antenna type. By default, UE antennas are isotropic. For fixed wireless access networks with directional antennas on customer premises equipment, download the antenna pattern in MSI format. It's assumed that CPE antennas are directed at the strongest BS sector signal at the CPE location. Directional antennas on CPE can significantly decrease interference from neighboring cells, thus enhancing CPE throughput. Base station sites can be created in RadioPlanner using various methods: import points with coordinates from a CSV file, enter coordinates manually, right-click on the desired location on the map. Upon site creation, one sector is automatically generated. In the sector parameters, you will configure the transceiver, cable, and antenna settings. It's also necessary to select the network to which the transceiver belongs and the MIMO type. Frequencies are chosen from the network's channel plan. For LTE and 5G networks, RadioPlanner includes the capability to use a single column antenna pattern to calculate reference signal received power and reference signal received quality for systems utilizing antenna beamforming technology. Often different sites share many parameters. In such cases, the global active sector parameters change feature is beneficial. Simply set the parameters for one sector, then apply them to all active sectors. The propagation model used here is Longley Rice, but you can also choose another model. In particular, the ITU-1812 propagation model is quite suitable for such a network. In the model parameters, you can specify time and location variability. If you do not want to take into account time and location variability, then set these values to 50%. Losses for different types of clutter can be entered manually, or they can be determined using the formulas of the ITU-1812 recommendation based on the average height of different types of clutter. The height for different types of clutter is specified in the geodata menu. Next, we'll explore various coverage prediction types for LTE and 5G networks. Received power maps show those areas where a given signal power level is present at the receiver. The legend displays the main project data, calculation parameters, and the results at the current point. You can set between 1 and 8 different received signal levels to simulate various reception conditions, such as outdoors, inside a vehicle, or indoors. For roof or tower-based customer premises equipment, CPE, only one signal level can be set. Coverage prediction accounts for co-channel interference, using frequency assignments for each sector, and adjacent channel interference, based on network settings parameters. Interference calculations always include the noise component, influenced by the noise bandwidth and receiver noise figure. Enter these settings in the noise and interference section of the network system settings. The required service carrier to interference plus noise ratio is the minimum SINR value needed by the receiver for acceptable performance. Acceptable varies in terms of subjective signal quality, so adjust this value to reflect systems of different or marginal quality. Areas with a carrier to interference plus noise ratio below the required threshold will be depicted on the map as interference zones. The best server map shows the identity of the sector supplying the strongest received signal at each location. The minimum received signal level for calculating the best server is downlink or uplink RX threshold. The sector color is defined in the sector parameters or can be assigned automatically. Areas with signal levels above both the base and mobile thresholds displays a map showing locations where both the signal received by the user equipment is above the downlink RX threshold and where the signal received by the base station sector from the UE is above the uplink RX threshold. This calculation can be performed for different conditions of use of a user equipment, such as indoors, outdoors, and inside a vehicle. Each condition of use has its own color and value of loss for signal penetration. For CPE, only outdoor calculation is performed. RSRP study calculates the reference signal received power from all resource elements of a cell at the user equipment receiver using system parameters of LTE and 5G networks, such as bandwidth and subcarrier spacing. The calculation can use a single column antenna pattern for a sector if selected in LTE 5G sector additional options. RSRQ study calculates the reference signal received quality from all resource elements at the remote UE receiver using system parameters of LTE and 5G networks such as bandwidth, subcarrier spacing, and cell load. The calculation can use a single column antenna pattern for a sector if selected in LTE 5G sector additional options. The carrier to interference plus noise ratio is an essential quantity used in assessing system performance and affecting frequency planning. RadioPlanner allows you to calculate and display areas with different CNR values for interference on co-channel and adjacent channels. The carrier to interference plus noise ratio is calculated by first finding the strongest received signal power at each location, then calculating the sum of received signal powers from all other co-channel and adjacent sectors, taking into account adjacent channel rejection that also have relevant signal levels at that location. After finding the sum of interference, the carrier to interference plus noise ratio is calculated. The interference calculation always takes into account the noise component, which depends on the noise bandwidth and receiver noise figure entered in noise and interference in the network system settings. The calculation of adjacent channel interference can be disabled to only take into account co-channel interference. This prediction type shows maximum cell throughput. For LTE 5G system types, this study calculates MCS index for each point based on predicted carrier to interference plus noise ratio from LTE and 5G system parameters tab. Throughput associated with MCS is determined using 3GPP specified formulas and tables. MIMO parameters are also taken into account on a per sector basis based on the settings specified in the network parameters. You can display up to 8 gradations of estimated throughput levels. Number of servers area study indicates the total number of sectors that provide a signal above the RX threshold at each location. In the point analysis menu, you can see the path profile and detailed results of the received signal power calculation at any point, as well as interference levels on co-channel and adjacent channels. Click on Point Analysis, then find the required sector in the interface tree and click on it. A path profile from the sector to the current point on the map will appear. You can change the current point on the map by clicking on the desired location. The path profile shows the height of the antenna radiation center of the selected base station and user equipment, as well as the Fresnel zone for the radio beam. Also loss in free space, diffraction loss due to terrain, and loss on clutter surrounding the mobile unit. In the Compare Coverage menu, you can compare the results of current coverage predictions with previously performed predictions. This allows you to evaluate the impact on coverage by changing various base station and UE parameters, propagation model, etc. To add a performed calculation to the comparison, click on Add Coverage to Compare on the top toolbar. You can add multiple calculations to comparisons, and their names will appear in the tree view interface under Compare Coverage. When you go to the Compare Coverage menu of the main toolbar, this calculation result will be located on the left side of the screen, while the result of the current coverage calculation will be displayed on the right side. If the legend is enabled, it will display calculation parameters that the mouse pointer is currently over. RadioPlanner 3 allows you to save coverage prediction results in various formats. Coverage prediction results can be saved as an interactive web page in HTML format that can be saved to your computer's disk or placed on a server. This web page allows you to select a base map, change scale, view basic data from the legend, and display scale and current cursor coordinates. You can save the coverage result in an image file in PNG format. Before saving an image, you can select the area of the saved coverage using the frame. You can move both borders of the frame and the map itself. If the legend is active, it will appear in the upper left corner. When saving images, you also select a resolution. The resolution may correspond with the current size or be 2 or 4 times larger. The higher the resolution, the larger the size of the saved file. You can save the coverage result in the KMZ Google Earth file. If the legend is active, it will appear in the upper left corner of Google Earth. Also, the result can be saved in GeoReference GeoTIFF format, as well as in a text CSV file or exchange file map info for further coverage analysis in various GIS applications. In the Reports menu, you can create different types of project reports: Network Configuration Report, Propagation Model Report, Area Study Type, and Active Sites Configuration Report. All types of reports open directly in Excel.